Good morning, everyone. My name is Justyna Skibińska, and today I will be talking about the transferable methodologies of detection sleep disorders thanks to the actigraphy device for Parkinson's disease detection. One of the main problems that society will face within 30 years is the population aging phenomena. The occurrence of neurodegenerative diseases is connected with the old age, and one of them is Parkinson's disease. When Parkinson's treatment is administered in the early stage, the impairment of health is significantly smaller thanks to the applied treatment. This is the reason why early detection of this disease is highly demanded. One of the symptoms which is observed in the early stage of PD are sleep disorders. For this purpose, the solution of IMHEAD will be highly appreciated. The sleep-related symptoms which are occurring are presented on the slide. I will start briefly describing them from rapid eye movement behavioral disorder. This is often mostly manifests in the elder age. The main symptom is loss of muscle tone during the REM part of the sleep. Patients may talk, gesture, kick, and could dream. The next symptom which could characterize PD patients is insomnia. Many PD patients, up to 60%, suffer from this symptom. The sleep fragmentation, like was earlier worked, is the most reported, whereas the initiation of sleep generally not change. Next, restless leg syndrome characterizes the urge to move the legs and peculiar. The unpleasant sensation is feeling in the legs. The release of this sensation mimics the movement of the limb. The mechanism of RLS in PD is not known. It's more visible in the cohort of PD patients than in healthy control. Excessive daytime sleepiness may be induced by dopaminergic drugs. It is reported that excessive daytime sleepiness may be associated with an increased risk of developing Parkinson's disease. What I can mention additionally, those symptoms are highly correlated to the dopamine level in the brain. Additionally, diffraction sleep is caused in PD by inter alia turning around in bed, frequent nocturia, nocturnal tremor, like with depression. For the detection of sleep disorder, many approaches have been used so far. For example, bed sensor, a wearable device including smartwatches, ultrasound, radio frequency, Wi-Fi sensors, video sonography, sleep diaries, electroencephalography. However, the gold standard in medical practice is considered polysomnography and is considered the most robust medical examination nowadays. PSG can avoid sleep disorder using various modalities. It includes registration of oximetry record, respiration, electromyography, EEG, electrocardiography, and electrooculography. There exist also other tests like continuous positive air pressure, video sonography, and accelerometry. Unfortunately, they are also tedious, more expensive, and uncomfortable for the patients, since often require hospital conditions to perform them. This is the reason why this approach struggles to detect possible issues in the early stages. On the right side, you can see the correlation between the user burden and accuracy. It is visible that the most comfortable for the patient is polysomnography, however, this methodology is the most accurate. This work is focused on overview of transferable methodology for Parkinson's disease detection, which were used earlier for another diseases or another based on another modality of PDP. Now I will be talking about the actigraph. So it's a kind of wearable device, and it's used for the detection inter alia of sleep disorders in PD patients. So actigraph is a term for a non-invasive method for monitoring human rest activity, cycles, and movements, and it is being used for monitoring resting time, sleeping time, activity time, or progression of diseases. The wearable actigraph devices are commonly equipped with sensors like accelerometer, gyroscope, and magnetometers for the registration of movement, rotation, and body position. Additional functionality could be provided by surface measurements such as hair, ambient, skin temperature, skin conductance, and sound. I will mention some methods which could be used for evaluation of sleep for PD patients, and they are commonly used. So there are sleep efficiency, lower sleep efficiency, longer wake after sleep onset, higher fragmentation index, shorter total sleep time, sleep onset latency, and nocturnal echokinesia. This work is focused on the methodologies which were earlier used for the detection of sleep disorder in the case of attention deficit hyperactivity, Alzheimer's disease. Additionally, some symptoms of PD were analyzed thanks to the active graphs like bradykinesia, the freezing of gait. So the algorithms which were used so far were KNN, super vector machines, JBoost, navigation classifiers, random forest, legless neural networks like convolutional neural network, LCM, gated recurrent unit, convolutional neural network with spectrograms. Additionally, they could be potentially applied ordinary differential equation, time over two-piece inverse covariance based clustering, deep actinet, bidirectional inversion of LSTM, 3D augmentation. That's not all, because also the handcrafted features could be used with classical classifiers, so the features could be based on time, statistic, morphology, Fourier transform, valence transform, kurtosis, variance, entropy, skewness, basic spectrum controller, coefficients of variation, percentage, and so on. Now I will describe some case studies. So, one medical dataset problem could often be the smallest amount of data, which could significantly influence the resulting accuracy. This is often a reason for not sufficient accuracy. One possible solution for the issue is the use of any data augmentation methods. It was introduces 3D augmentation, time-wise scaling, magnitude scaling, and random rotation. Also, the normalization of the data and dealing with an imbalanced dataset are regarded as essential steps in creating robust models. The authors use smartphone collecting data. They came from the Dream Parkinson Disease Digital Biomarkers Challenge. The gait of patient was recorded, which will be characterized by changes in walking pace, irregular cycling pattern, or tremor during the quiet standing period. They have outperformed the state-of-the-art result thanks to the normalization, augmentation, and CNN. They achieved 87 area under the curve, and the results of this are visible on the right side in the corner. So for the original data classification, for including normalization, augmentation, and both approaches. Additionally, you can see here the what kind of augmentation they were used. So it was perturbation of magnitude, temporal perturbation, or a random rotation. Very interesting time-aware and low-cost architecture was presented for predicting Alzheimer's disease with actigraphy data. Time-aware triplets, inverse covariance-based clustering, and convolutional neural networks. TICC is an unsupervised method dedicated to recognize states such as sleeping or exercising, and convolutional neural network can learn temporal futures from time series. Subsequently, it is using a time-aware solution to capture a circadian rhythm. The novelty lies in time series classification methods, since the previous methods were not able to distinguish between those signals which were recorded at a different time of the day, for example, at night and during the day. This time-aware mechanism considers the crucial part of the day as much more meaningful than data taken at another time. Whereas architectures like LSTM or GMO could analyze the long-term temporal dependencies. The authors use a combination of those approaches, actually 86.2% area under curve, and on the comparable level, the sensitivity and specificity. You can see the highest attention was observable between 4 and 5 a.m. Typical time for wake up of the elderly, and it is visible on the right side in the corner. You can see also the architecture on the left side. In another world, the researchers converted the traction accelerometer signals into spectrograms. They have tested their architecture on three datasets, including the Daphne freezing of gait dataset of PD patients. The methodology is composed of two steps, the unsupervised pre-training step and the supervised discriminative step. With the usage of deep belief networks, they succeed in freezing gait recognition in 91.5% accuracy. This pre-training, it is with future extraction, allows achieving a better quality of predictions. On the left side, you can see the used architecture, whereas on the right side, it is visible the data, which represents samples of tracer axonometer and the spectrogram. The samples represent human activity. It is jogging, upstairs, downstairs, sitting and standing. Other scientists also use CNS with spectrograms, but for HD recognition and obtain 98.6 accuracy for 300-second window length. Furthermore, they have used the aggregate signal as the magnitude of three axes and normalization of the data. They have also profiled the signals with lower activity not to interfere with them with the available signal for detecting this disease. They found that the choice of the window length influenced the obtained accuracy. The best results were achieved using medium sized window length. However, for Parkinson disease, it could be different. You can see the use architecture of the left side and the spectrographs for different length of the window. It's 60-second window and 300-second window for disease and for the healthy control, so it is visible that they differ. The next application of neural networks for analyzing sleep is presented. The authors have used deep actinet, which contains 1D CNN and LSTM for sleep-awake status detection. They compared this method with another machine learning algorithm such as random forest, naive wave, linear discriminant analysis, future-based convolutional neural network, and two older, relatively frequently used algorithms, Sadler-Cole-Kripke. The proposed model has outperformed the rest of the algorithm and has achieved 89.65% accuracy. Other researchers use the bidirectional version of LSTM for sleep-awake recognition, where they achieve 96.5% accuracy. They use the signals of three-axis acceleration and skin temperature and tested various signals, but those mentioned above were reported to be the best. They have highlighted the real-time LSTM gave results smaller by 0.2 to 1%, so this solution will be adequate for real-time application. You can see on this picture what kind of the combination with sensor or phone, with skin conductance, skin temperature, accelerometer signals, what kind of the results were achieved. So for the accelerometer and skin temperature, it was the highest. The aim of this presentation was to point out the methodologies which could be transferred for PD detection. So I will now mention which of them were presented. First of all, 3D data augmentation, because increasing the number of the data could also increase the accuracy. The augmentation was in the temporal and spatial domain. Moreover, very interesting time-aware attention mechanism was introduced for monitoring circadian rhythm inter alia, and the same could detect very wide changes in sleep disorders of Parkinson's disease. Additionally, using spectrograms which contain a future dependency could be successfully applied from tracheal accelerometer for detection of sleep disorders in Parkinson's disease. Moreover, combination of some architecture like 1D CNN and LSTM could give good results. Moreover, adding extra modalities could improve prediction, like for example skin temperature in comparison to the common smartwatches. Bidirectional LSTM could improve prediction, and that's not all, because it should not be forgotten that standard future extraction to Radon with classical classifiers could also be applied with a good results. So, like mentioned, the great potential has this time-aware attention mechanism because it's monitoring circadian rhythm. Thank you for your attention.